don't think so. When do I light mine?
You're the fourth kid.
No, she lights the first three.
Yeah, she lights.
Then I guess the fourth.
The second one.
The fourth kid is the one I hired, adult age. Sorry.
Oh, so you're Lena, right? Okay, Lena, you will light the fourth kid. So when you look up there and there's three lit, you'll be lighting the fourth one.
And then I'll light the fifth.
Okay, so I go light that and then I'm done because then you are up.
You're a light one.
I'm gonna go right after I read my little ability. And where's the thin lighter? Is it up there?
Basically, what we do.
It's a green.
Basically. Basically, the candle gets lit after the story. After your story. See, that doesn't, it says the story's in here, but it doesn't elaborate on this thing right here. But after you read your story, then you light the fourth candle.
Yep. That's it. Go ahead.
Okay, so I don't light it here. So there's no candle.
No. When we do our stories, we light it.
Good afternoon. Thank you for joining us today as we gather to worship as the community of Dwight and the body of Christ. This is our World Day of Prayer service sponsored by the Dwight Ministerial Association, where we will be collecting an offering towards the end of the service. And if you need to, you can make checks payable to the Dwight United Methodist Church, and we will be sure that that goes into the general offering for this day. We also want to invite you to a time of refreshments following the service. We have some special treats that have been prepared by many from our United Methodist Women's Group that have some scones and some other tasty treats from some of the countries that we are talking about today. Today's service theme is on the British Isles and those three countries included in that, as you'll hear during the service. Let's pray together, friends. Most loving and gracious God, our Heavenly Father, as we come to you on this day of prayer, we're mindful of our world that is full of brokenness and pain. We're especially mindful of those who are living in poverty, who do not know where their next meal might come from, who do not know where the bills, how the bills will be paid, who do not experience safety. We are mindful of those who are being invaded by foreign countries. We are especially mindful of the people of Ukraine and ask that your great protection be draped over them. We pray for those who have flown to exile, those who are fearful for loved ones left behind, that they might also feel peace. We're mindful of those in our own community who struggle hidden from our eyes. We pray, O Lord, in the coming days of Lent that we may see them anew and that we may reach out to them with your love and your compassion, that we may be generous in sharing all the bounty that you have given to us. Often the needs are not physical, but emotional and spiritual. So help us, O Lord, to show grace, offer forgiveness, offer tender mercy, a welcoming smile, a friendship, and especially to share Jesus with them. Help us anew to find ways to communicate your great love in Jesus to the people that we meet, and especially to those that we have not yet met, that all may come to know your great love. So empower us through your Holy Spirit this day to truly be your people and pour out your love and mercy, especially on those who have great needs. We ask this all in the name of Jesus, and we thank you for your great love that we know best through him. Amen.
In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth, God said, "Let there be light." God, our eternal parent and our Father, we light a candle of hope to celebrate with all your people as we watch and wait for your plans and promises to be fulfilled. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned.
God of hope, in our brothers, may we find space to see you at work in our lives and our world. May we be people who radiate your hope as we worship the celebration today. Amen.
Again, welcome to our World Day of Prayer service as we celebrate the seven regions of the world. Warmest greetings from the women of England, and our seven candles represent those seven regions. We welcome you from the women of England, Wales, and Northern Ireland, the three countries that are part of the United Kingdom. And together with Scotland, they are the British Isles, situated in Northwest Europe. We rejoice that although they have many things in common, they are a diverse people. Over the years, the British Isles have welcomed people from all corners of the earth, some who have chosen to come, and others who have are refugees fleeing from the persecution in their own lands, like the people of Ukraine. Today, the country is multi-ethnic, multicultural, and multi-faith society. England, Wales, and Northern Ireland are proud of the diversity and anxious to preserve the differences of language and culture. We rejoice with them in this. We rejoice in the variety of natural beauty found in the British Isles, the mountains and craggy moorland, its fertile fields and pasture lands, its rolling downs and spectacular coastal scenery. its small, beautiful islands. The theme of our service is God's promises found in the book of Jeremiah. I know the plans I have for you, focusing on freedom, forgiveness, justice, and God's peace. Let us see how this promise can be fulfilled as a sign of hope for all of people. Let's stand together and sing our opening praise. It's in our hymnals, number 469. Jesus is all the world to me. We'll sing verses 1-3. You may be seated. The prophet Jeremiah lived some 600 years before the birth of Christ, at a time of great political crisis. The southern kingdom of Judah had been invaded by the Babylonians and many of its people taken from Jerusalem into exile. The people had lost the land they believed God had given them, and they longed to return, but the future looked bleak. Our chosen message is part of a letter from Jeremiah, setting out God's plan for the exiles. They are to stay where they are and make new lives for themselves in this foreign land.
This is from Jeremiah 29. These are the words of the letter that the prophet Jeremiah sent from Jerusalem to the remaining elders among the exiles and to the priests, the prophets, and all the people. Nebuchadnezzar had taken into exile from Jerusalem to Babylon. This was after King Jeconiah and the queen mother, the court officials, the leaders of Judah and Jerusalem, the artisans, and the smiths had departed from Jerusalem.
Thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, to all the exiles whom I have sent into exile from Jerusalem to Babylon, build houses and live in them. Plant gardens and eat what they produce. Take wives and have sons and daughters. Take wives for your sons and give your daughters in marriage, that they may have sons and daughters. Multiply there and do not decrease, but seek the welfare of the city where I have sent you into exile, and pray to the Lord on its behalf, for in its welfare you will find your welfare. For thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, do not let the prophets and the diviners who are among you deceive you, and do not listen to the dreamers, to the dreams that they dream. For it is a lie that they have prophesied to you in my name. I have not sent them, says the Lord.
For thus says the Lord, only when Babylon's 70 years are completed will I visit you, and I will fulfill to you my promise and bring you back to this place. For surely I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord, plans for your welfare and not for harm, to give you a future with hope. Then, when you call upon me and come and pray to me, I will hear you. When you search for me, you will find me. If you seek me with all your heart, I will let you find me, says the Lord. And I will restore your fortunes and gather you from all the nations and all the places where I have driven you, says the Lord. And I will bring you back to the place from which I sent you into exile. Praise be the word of God.
Amen.
Now, if you will stand again and sing with us hymn 496, Sweet Hour of Prayer.
Thank you.
Let us pray together. God, our eternal parent and our loving Heavenly Father, we light a candle of hope to celebrate with all your people as we watch and wait for your plans and promises to be fulfilled. And now let us confess our sins. God told the people of Judah to care for the people and the place where they had been exiled. Often we fall short of caring for God's world and God's people. So let us bring those times to God and seek God's forgiveness.
Merciful God, we come to you in confession. We are aware that much of the suffering of our sisters and brothers across the world is a result of our colonial past. We acknowledge this and are sorry that as a country, we have often put ourselves first at the expense of others. Gracious God, forgive us. God, in your mercy, forgive us. We think of your beautiful world, how we have taken it for granted and squandered its resources. Generous God, forgive us. God, in your mercy, forgive us. Our fellow sisters and brothers cry out to you. We have failed to love them well. We have not loved our neighbors as you have taught us. Sometimes we have not even loved ourselves. Compassionate God, forgive us. God, in your mercy, forgive us. God, in your mercy, help us to act on your call for repentance. Jesus, thank you that through your sacrifice we have been forgiven. Holy Spirit, transform our hearts and our minds so that we may live and love as Jesus showed us. Amen. Amen.
The people of Jeremiah's time found themselves in a place where they did not want to be, away from their homeland and excluded from their culture and worship and their homes. There are many people who have settled in the British Isles after having fled their homeland and culture. In a land of prosperity, there are those who are poor. In the midst of crowded cities, there are many who are lonely. How can we tell all their stories? Well, we can't. But we can hear voices telling us to listen to and what it means to be feeling excluded. People who felt excluded in England, Wales, and Northern Ireland. People who feel excluded amongst us. So what does it mean to feel excluded in these places?
Living in poverty. Regularly missing a meal so that my children might not go hungry.
Living in fear because my partner abuses me physically, emotionally, and sexually.
Living in loneliness and isolation because of my age, my disabilities, ethnic origin, or my sexuality. Now we're going to please stand and sing song 352, It's Me, O Lord.
Thank you.
May be seated. Let us pray together. God, our eternal parent and our Father, we light a candle of hope to celebrate with all your people as we watch and wait for your plans and promises to be fulfilled. Let's hear our stories of hope. There are times when our lives that we find ourselves in situations that we don't want to be. Sometimes, like the exiles in Babylon, we cannot see a way forward and long for God to intervene. When God does, it's often in ways that we did not imagine or not at all as we expected. So let's listen to these true stories of three women who found themselves living in difficult situations and how God's plan for them have blessed them in very unexpected way. First, we'll hear Lena's story.
My name is Lena, and I have helped my son to bring up my four grandsons after their mother left them. My son struggles with mental health issues and cannot work, so there is very little money for even their basic needs. I used to go without food myself in order to buy food for them, for him and the boys. 5 years ago, my grandsons attended an event at my local church, where they were welcomed warmly. Since then, this church has become our wider family. They help us with regular donations of food from the food bank and have helped us with clothing and holidays for the family. One member of the congregation is a retired teacher and helped the grandchildren with their homework on a Wednesday night. Through the love of this church, we have found a safe space, people who love us and will not let us down. I thank God for the way that he has worked out his plans to bless us, to give us hope and a future through my local church.
Let us pray together. God, our eternal parent and our Father, we light a candle of hope to celebrate with all your people as we watch and wait for your plans and promises to be fulfilled. Now hear Natalie's story.
It doesn't always feel like fear when I'm with him. Mostly I feel uneasy, like I'm treading on eggshells, unsure of what's going to be to do next or what he is going to make me do next. His indifference towards me stings. His unkindness shrivels me up inside. His threats make me paranoid. God is a weapon he uses to control me. I'm a shell of who I used to be. When I was pregnant, he hurt me so badly that the baby was born early. In the days I spent in the hospital, not knowing if my child would live, God spoke to me. Stop praying for your child to live. Instead, pray for my will to be done. I said yes to God, who offered only to be present, with no promises that everything would be okay. And yet, my baby is now 13 years old, happy and healthy. My life has been filled with more joy and beauty than I ever thought possible, and I am free from the man who abused me so terribly. No longer do I fear. God has got good plans for me.
Let Let us pray together. God, our eternal parent and our Father, we light a candle of hope to celebrate with all your people as we watch and wait for your plans and promises to be fulfilled. Now we'll hear Emily's story.
I had plans for my life. I would go to university. I'd become a teacher. But when I was 16, I was diagnosed with brain tumors and needed lots of surgery. One operation saved my life, but caused me to lose my hearing. I was terrified in my world of silence. All thoughts of a career in education had vanished. I struggled to understand what people said to me as I watched their lips move. I struggled to understand sign language, too. I felt caught between the hearing world and the deaf world, fitting into neither. I became very isolated and withdrawn. I wanted to end my life, but God had other plans. As I gradually accepted that my plans could not happen, I asked God to use my life for His glory, and He began to show me His plans. He wanted me to use my story for Him. He knows the plans that He has for me, and I have learned that I do not need to know them. I need to trust Him. I am better at lip reading and sign language now, although I still struggle to understand what people say sometimes. But I know that wherever I go, through God, God whispers His peace and love into my heart, and I do not need to be able to hear to know His whisper.
Let us pray together. God, our eternal parent and our Father, we light a candle of hope to celebrate with all your people as we watch and wait for your plans and promises to be fulfilled.
The people walking in darkness have seen a great light.
Jesus said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. John 8:12.
God promises freedom, forgiveness, justice, and peace. And these promises are fulfilled in Jesus. He is the light-giving life of the world, which even the deepest darkness cannot extinguish. It is through Jesus that we are able to come close to God and discern God's plans for us.
God of the past, the present, and the future. We thank you that you love us faithfully and uniquely. You loved us before we knew anything about you. You cared for us in every moment of our lives. You know our deepest thoughts, our highest hopes, and our greatest fears. You know the best and the worst in us, and still you love us. Thank you that you never let us go. Thank you for the plans and the promises you have made for us, which give us hope for today and tomorrow. God of our past, our present, and our future, receive our thanks and praise, which we offer in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
As we reflect upon God's promise to the people of Judah, at each pause, feel free to write or draw your thoughts, or simply think silently, for surely I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. plans for your welfare and not for harm, to give you a future with hope. Then when you call upon me and come and pray to me, I will hear you. Jeremiah 29:11. As you came in, you were given or picked up perhaps a packet of seeds or a seed. A seed is full of potential and hope. Hold your seeds and ponder. What might God be saying to you? What hope does God have for your future? Pause to think and write down or draw your thoughts. We pray for what is in our hearts. So think for a moment. What stops you from hearing God's call? We pray that we might hear God's voice. Listen. Seeds need the right conditions to grow. Where do seeds of hope need planting in your life? In your community? Where do seeds of hope need planting in your country? How can these seeds of hope be nourished in your life, in your community, in your country? We pray for these places and situations. Now, take these seeds and plant them as a reminder of God's constant love and your hopes. A seventh candle is lit as we say, join together.
God, our eternal parent and our loving Father, we light the candle of hope and participate with all your people in responsive, prayerful action to bring to life the plans and promises you have for us.
Let us pray for all who are hungry and do not have enough to live with dignity, that they may find generosity in our communities. God, in your mercy,
hear
our prayer. For all who have been abused in any way, whose homes or places of study or work are places not of safety, but of fear, that they might be strengthened and freed from the abusers of fear. God, in your mercy,
hear
our prayer. For all who live in loneliness or isolation, that they may know friendship and community. God, in your mercy,
hear
our prayer. For all who have been displaced, who live in exile and in fear of losing everything they have ever known, that they may know God's peace and strength in their lives. God, in your mercy,
hear
our prayer. Let us commend ourselves and all for whom we pray to the mercy and protection of God, in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Now let us pray the prayer that Jesus taught us.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Faithful God, knowing that your plans for our lives are good and your promises to be trusted, we offer these gifts in praise and thanksgiving. May they be used according to your will for the benefit of all your people.
And now we'll invite the ushers to come forward and receive this afternoon's offerings. Let us pray together. Loving and gracious Heavenly Father, thank you for the bounties that we have received, for calling on our lives and inviting us to participate in your work around our world through our generous giving, through our volunteering, through our loving gestures, words, and deeds. Receive these tithes and offerings and multiply them. Empower us, O Lord, to use all our resources to further your kingdom here on earth until Jesus comes in final victory. It is in his precious name that we always pray. Amen. And now let's stand together and sing our closing praise, Let There Be Peace on Earth, number 431.
Thank you.
We thank you, loving God, that we have been gathered in your presence and shared in worship. Now may we go forth into the world, confident that we are your children, knowing that you have called us by name. In our daily life, may we align ourselves to your will, seeking direction to follow your plan and patience in waiting. In the challenges and joys we face, may we be assured we do not face them alone. Let us go in peace, hope, and love. In the name of God, our Mother, and our Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen. Now we invite you to depart to our fellowship hall for a time of fellowship and refreshment.